हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू इंडियाज़ लार्जेस्ट लाइव लर्निंग प्लेटफॉर्म ग्रेडअप। ग्रेडअप है तो सही प्रेप है, सही प्रेप है तो लाइफ सेट है। एंड वेलकम टू द कैप्सूल सीरीज। द टुडेज कैप्सूल, कैप्सूल नंबर 4 इज सेक्टर नंबरिंग एंड सेक्टर एड्रेसिंग। होप यू आर फॉलोइंग दिस कैप्सूल सीरीज। If you have missed by chance the previous capsules, capsule 1, 2 and 3, please find them. That will be available in our GradeUp Gate YouTube channel. So please refer to them in your free time. So without any delay, let us get into the session. This is quick detail about me. You may follow my Telegram group to ask any doubts or to interact with me. Now, to understand sector numbering and sector addressing, first of all, what is a sector? We understood that a hard disk will have multiple platters, each platter will have two recording surfaces. Right, on the top and on the bottom, and each surface is concentric, is partitioned into concentric circles called tracks, and every surface will have equal number of tracks. And each track is further partitioned into sectors. Each track is further partitioned into sectors, and each track will have equal number of sectors. How that is possible? A small track and big track will have equal number of sectors by varying density. But this is not the case in CD, DVD. So that we will discuss as tomorrow's capsule, capsule number 5. So stay tuned for that CLV and CAV capsule. Anyhow, so a track, a platter is partitioned as two surfaces, surface is partitioned as tracks, track is partitioned into sectors. And what will be one sector is equal to half kilobyte or 512 bytes. And we also understood that in the hard disk functionality, at a time, how much can be accessed? One sector can be accessed at a time. At a time, one sector can be accessed. This sector may be in the range of read-write head. If not, disk rotation happens. And if the sector is on the bottom surface or middle surface, not on the top, because to access that sector, it would be difficult with only one read-write head, each surface will have its own read-write head. So, number of surfaces is equal to number of heads. In the other way, we can also say surface number is also equal to head number. Why only one sector can be accessed at a time? Because the disk is sector addressable. The disk is sector addressable means one sector will have one unique address. How that address looks like, we will see now. Before that, how the data, how these sectors are aligned or arranged means, suppose this is the spindle. Assume there are two platters, so each platter is having two surfaces. Let's say this is surface number 0, this is surface number 1. These two together is first platter, platter number 0. Similarly, this is surface number 2, this is surface number 3. These two together is what? Platter number 1. Okay. Now, how the sectors are arranged means, always remember, in the hard disk, first the top surface, the top surface innermost track is filled. So let's say, let assume there are 4 sectors per track. So the first 4 sectors are arranged like this. Once the top surface first track is filled, don't think the next track is filled immediately. No, where the next sector will be on the first track of second surface here. Once it gets filled, the further sectors will be on the first track of next surface. Once this is filled, next surface first track gets filled. Like this, how many surfaces there are, all the surfaces that particular track, once it fill, then only the next track filling will start. So as we assumed there are 4 surfaces, 4 surfaces first track got filled, now the next sector will fill in the second track of first surface. After this, second track of next surface, and so on. Like this, the sectors are arranged. So the sector numbering would be like this, consolidated. But how? They are not like first completely one surface is filled. On any surface, one track will be filled at any time. Then it moves to next surface. So this arrangement is what we say cylinder alignment. What? Cylinder alignment. What is cylinder? All first tracks called one cylinder. All second track is one cylinder. So all second tracks are together called one cylinder. All third tracks together is one cylinder. Like this, sectors are arranged how? Cylinder wise. So what is a cylinder? Collection of one track sectors from each surface. So for any cylinder from any surface, how many tracks will come, will be contributed? One track. So all first tracks is cylinder 1, all second tracks is cylinder 2. So number of cylinders is equal to what? How, what we can say? Number of cylinders will be equal to number of tracks per surface. Also, what we can also say, track number and cylinder number will be same, isn't it? Track number will always be equal to cylinder number, because all track zeros together is cylinder zero, all track ones from every surface together is cylinder one. So track number, cylinder number will be same. On one surface how many tracks are there, total those many cylinders will be there. Got it? I hope cylinder concept is clear. Now to understand how this particular sector is identified by the read write head, before that let me introduce our courses for 2022 and 2023 GATE aspirants in both English and Hindi medium, that is Vision. In each you will be getting everything in terms of live classes, mock test, practice questions, study notes, everything you will get that is needed to crack your GATE exam with a very good rank. So subscribe to Grade Up Super to get the lectures from the expert faculty, Murali sir, Deva sir, Satish Yadav sir, Ankit sir, Navneet sir, Anshul sir, all are very well experienced. So guys, have no doubt, stick to Grade Up, switch to Grade Up, take super subscription. Alright, so now assume this is how the sectors are numbered. Now how the sector address would be? Sector address always represented by three parameters, C, H, S. What is C? C stands for cylinder number, H stands for head number, S stands for sector number, means from which surface, which track, which sector we want. Indirectly, that is what the address will be. So here all these first tracks together is what? This is what? Cylinder zero. All next tracks together is what? Cylinder one. And this is the surface zero. This is the surface one. This is the surface two. This is surface three. Right? Now, suppose I would like to identify a sector with address, with number 18. Suppose I would like to identify this sector. How I identify? On which cylinder it is? You see, that is the second track of that surface, means track one of that surface. Numbering always starts with a zero. So the cylinder number is one. On which surface it is? Zero. Here head number is equal to surface number. We have already discussed it. Cylinder number is always equal to track number, isn't it? So on which surface it is? Surface number zero. On that surface, on that track, 18 is which sector? 16, 17, 18. Third sector. Third means you start numbering with 0, 0, 1, 2. So on that surface, on that track, it is of sector number 2. So the address of sector number 18 is 102. Similarly, I want the address of, let's say, sector number 8. So how I will write? It is on which cylinder? Cylinder number 0. Surface? Surface number 2. On that it is very first sector, 8. So 0. Right? In the same way, suppose I want to identify the sector number 23. So how the address would be? It is on cylinder number 1, surface number 1, on that it is 20, 21, 22, 23. 0, 1, 2, 3. So the sector number would be 3. Right? In the same way, suppose I would like to identify 13. So how the address would be? This is on cylinder 0, surface 3. On that cylinder, on that surface, it is 12, 13, 0, 1, sector number 1. So this is how we will give the sector address. So sector address is always composition of C, H, S. Now, if address is given, how do you get the number? The consolidated sector number for address CHS is always given as C into total number of surfaces into total number of sectors per track. Total sectors per track means number of sectors per track plus H into number of sectors per track plus S. So this is the formula to calculate the sector number for given CHS. For example, you are given there are 16 surfaces, 256 sectors per track. Suppose it is given like this. And what is the sector number for 10, 15, comma, let's say 50. So what is the sector number for this address? Substitute 10 into C into number of surfaces 16, number of sectors per track 256 plus H 15 into number of sectors per track 256 plus S. Whatever the value, this is 160 into 256. 160 into 256 plus 15 into 256 plus 50. So let me use my calculator. So this would be 175 into 256, that is 44800 plus 80 plus 50, sorry. So you will get the consolidated sector number as 44850. So this is how you will convert sector address to sector number. I hope how the sectors are numbered, how the address is given, how this translation happens is clear with this capsule. So stay tuned and keep waiting for the next capsule, that is CLV and CAV, disk rotations. This is our Grade Up Gate Hall of Fame, 100 plus Grade Up students achieved under 100 in 2021, 10 plus gradients are there under top 10. So take super subscription and enjoy all the structured live courses. Thank you so much for watching, and this is my Telegram group. You may join for interacting with me. See you in the next capsule session. Till then, have a great day. Before you leave, don't forget to like the session, share it and subscribe. Thank you guys. Bye-bye.